A new week, so this is probably my third or maybe even fourth week on this project, and I still haven't made that much work, so I gotta keep going and going and going, because this thing does not work just by itself. So let's first see if I could tie a few loose ends again that I neglected to do earlier. And then especially I have some things on my mind, like for example evens. I think that evens has an option to open a PDF in a location. So graphics, events, and then there's here opening containing folder. So what that means is that it needs to run Nautilus. So that, and we probably haven't supported that yet. So it should be pretty easy to accomplish, actually. Let's see. And then basically go to events, or events. And here is basically all we have to do is just append the runs Nautilus, and that's basically tying a loose end. So now basically, if you open a PDF and then you'll say open in location, open file in location or something like that, then Nautilus will be able to run, events will be able to run Nautilus with a domain transition to the restricted Nautilus domain. Alright, so that's done, and let's have a look at some of the stuff that we basically need to focus on first before we can get to the nice stuff, or to the stuff that basically is not super mandatory. And I have something in my mind, which is the actual BitTorrent client. There's other stuff that we need to do, for example that backup solution, and the backup solution is probably also a rather big piece of the puzzle, Datadub. So we have basically Datadub here, and what else do we have? Transmission TTK. So we should probably focus on transmission TTK today, because that might be reasonably simple. And yeah, we still need to do some Nautilus components, like Nautilus Connect Server. I'm not sure that whether Nautilus actually still uses that in GNOME 3.6. Well, probably does, or maybe it doesn't. I'm not sure just still. But we're going to leave that for another day, because you need to basically set up SSH, and I do have an idea how to simply test that without doing too much stuff. But for now, I'm just ignoring it. So transmission TTK. That's basically, and I'll just first transmission TTK. Yeah. Basically first going to build this. I'm not going to actually test that functionality currently. Might do that later. I can't test everything all the time. So this is installing, and then I'm going to focus on transmission. First, I'll just have a look where it is, what it is. Let's see, our search. am ACTS today. Actually, 8:40, not 9:40. Yeah, it's early, 8 o'clock in the morning, almost 9 o'clock. So I need to wake up, still drinking the coffee and stuff. It's clean. So I'm going to basically just run, try and run the transmission TTK in a enforcing mode. So it, although it is allowed to actually execute it, it's not allowed to actually run it because it's not allowed to execute no trans. Let's see where that is. Internet probably, isn't it? Here's the transmission transmission thing. So we're running it now. I'm getting a fail to execute, permission denied. Let's see what I'm getting. See, transmission TTK read open. So that means that there's actually a that shell actually needs to be able to run transmission TTK, at least conditionally. But we'll add in conditionals later because that's not important. So yeah, we're going to do that. We're going to transmission TTK. Oh, that doesn't isn't really needed. So like sysmon, transmission TTK is also run by the shell. So we can basically copy this stuff over here and add that in here. And then basically yeah, replace, and that'll take care of the actual transition. So transition TTK probably yeah, needs full access to generic user home content, because you want to basically save your torrents in your home directory as generic content, and your seeds or whatever. Yeah, I'm not sure how that works, but we'll see. Guess we're gonna have to test it, at least in some sense. But probably a full read and write to generic, to your user home there as generic content. So this sets it all up, I guess. Yeah, pretty much, except this here. So let's just get it going. After that, we also need to take care of the data, which is actually pretty. We can't actually do that right now because we need to also take care of GPT for that. So that's basically, GPT is a prerequisite. All right. So, all right. Let's just go to permissive mode, set enforce 0, to get a look at what it actually requires. So the menu, and the internet, and then TTK. And there you have it. Transmission is a file sharing program, is it? When you run a torrent, its data will be made available to others by means of upload. You and you alone are fully responsible for the exercising proper judgment and abiding your local laws. Okay. I guess that was a mandatory notice. So let's have a look at what it wants just to start up. And here we have the stuff that we need to get it going. Copy this over and then just have a look at it later when we paste it in. Okay, where is transmission? Paste it in. And then just deal with this stuff. So let you know the deal. We're first going to have a overlook and search for transitions first and creations. So there seems to be no actual transition going on as far as I can see, no execute. So it doesn't actually execute anything as far as I can see. But it does actually create some stuff. For example, here it's creating a dir in config. So that's probably period config transmission or something like that. We're gonna have a take a look at that. And that's basically this one right here. Grab create. That's probably enough. Yeah. So yeah, it's creating a transmission dir in config. So let's have a look at that. LSRC home my login user config. And there's a transmission there and there. And we want to basically protect that. So yeah, we know what to do. Transmission. FC. Config. Where are you? Yeah. So. Config. Transmission, not transition. Transmission. So that's set up. And go to TE file. Where is transmission? Set that up. This is basically this first line here. And this basically we need to do a couple of things. So first of all, transmission will need basically access to generic home content, so we can basically borrow a couple of things already from a program that has similar properties, like for example this here, this one here, file roller. So this stuff here can actually be reused. So let's paste that in already and take care of that first and replace it. This is basically for traversing your home directory or the home root, and then basically actually listing the home directory and all the directories in there. That's basically so that if you open up your file dialog, that you'll have a decent overview. So above that, that's basically the mandatory stuff for now. And this is then config. So we are going to copy this a couple times and then basically take care of the new type. So we have a new type here. It's called type. Transmission config home t, and I'll copy that over of one time and then make that a type transition or type attribute, and that's file type as first, and then it's also a user home type. Okay, so don't mind the noise, the boys are still working hard on the roof. So this is that, and this is that. It's probably also need to probably need to read, but let's have a look. I'll be glad when that is done. The roofing. Transmission. All right, so that's set up. This should be the basics. It's also going to create a file in there, but we don't have a trace for that yet. So we have data. So that means that it needs to traverse local and then get to share. So you need deconf search and data hunting search. So we have that also. Probably somewhere here. Actually, it might not be this one here. Yeah, this year. So that's another thing that we need. Basically, a lot of this stuff is just the basics. So that's these two. This can be removed, and the tconf can be removed if it's there, and there can also be other stuff removed, by the way. So for example, this user home dirty and user home t can be removed. We'll take care of that. And we need to actually allow this one also with in the conf part. Homotic is already allowed because that's basically needed to traverse. I can basically add this here below because it's kind of the same location, just another file, another classified file. But it's reading the xdg config file, which is in a period config. This get attributes and. Oh, this is, it's executing itself. So we can basically also keep that in. So what else do we have? We have Ibis related stuff. Let's start by first things first, which is forms. Here we have forms for Sysmon, GNOME Sysmonitor. So that takes care of the fonts. We have X server interaction and XDM interaction. This is also something that they all use. So where is it? Sysmon should be using that as well. Oh, here you have actually Ebus. That doesn't look complete. This is the X server stuff. I think it is complete, that Ebus stuff, but we just don't have the full picture, because we probably only happens if you actually use Ebus. And I don't actually use it. So yeah, that's just some functionality that I just haven't tested. But at least it has the basics out of the way. Oh man, this is annoying. Okay, so this can be removed because we moved that up. This, we just added the X server stuff. And the tempfs file also took care of that. So now we have a couple of things. It's connecting to the session bus here. It's reading network state. It's reading system state. It's connecting to the network. Yeah, that's obvious. That's what these things do. But yeah, that Ebus stuff, let's take care of that first. And also it's doing some system file up. Let's take that first. We're going to just, in the previous example, I basically decided to that if it domain wants that, then it probably wants to connect to the system bus. But I didn't actually apply that everywhere. So for example, I didn't apply it for gsysmon, because I have no clue why gsysmon would want to which system service it would want to chat. So I'm just going to take this as a base, use this as a base, and then if I just later on identify, okay, yeah, that's why it needs it, because it wants to chat to this and that system service, then I'm going to actually add the remainder. So this can be removed. All right, Ebus. I'm going to take it from not from. I'm going to take it from somewhere else, just to make sure that here it is. And it's really just about reading a dir, a set attributes and get attributes of a dir. And also this file system stuff, but we don't really need to add that from here. I'll just add that where the other stuff is with regard to config. Keep it a little bit structured. So yeah, that's taken care of. Let's make this a little bit structured. This seems fine, this seems fine. Procnet T, this seems fine, this seems fine. This is probably going to need some more work. Yeah, we can basically leave this the way it is right here for now. Let's first have a look some at the menu a little. But there are probably some obvious things. Like, for example, Yelp. Contents, Yelp. That's an obvious one. Open URL, references, view, statistics, contents. So Yelp is an obvious thing. And oh yeah, and also that open stuff for your file that you also need to take care of. So first runs Yelp. This application runs Yelp. And probably also runs Nautilus, but we're going to not do that for now. Oh yeah, and we're going to take care of user home space. So we can get that from file roller. This stuff here is not. Actually needed all this. I'm going to remove this. At least some of this stuff. But actually, let's just keep it in. But it's not, I'm just saying that it's not really all that important. So where is that user home stuff here? Actually, let's take that from, which was the last one that we did. Maybe Nautilus is a good idea. Probably also needs TTK. Okay. I think it's kind of hard to tell. I'll leave it at kind of hard to tell. These are diamonds. I need events. Where the heck is events? Although events also copy stuff to the home there, and it's not actually what it. I have now also copy stuff. You know what, I'll just leave it for now. I'll just leave it for now, though. So, we had the basics out of the way, haven't we? Runs Yelp, we took care of that as well. So yeah, I'm just waiting to. I'm not going to make any assumptions. Here we have an unknown type trend, and this is typo. an early morning typo. Do we have any more early morning typos? Probably, but can't see them right here. Yep. Unknown type transmission. Any more early morning typos? Yeah, we have some missing requirements. Some missing requirements, and I'll just add them here. So one of them was the netconf t type. I'll just make a new block, because it's going to be pretty much netconf t type, but there were probably other stuffs. I think the process set shed. Actually, let's just copy that in like that. That was one of them. And we probably need the notes stuff here. So we'll add that in. Actually, it's TCP socket. So I'll probably type note D also, although I'm not sure because we might already have that, but it's not that important. TCP socket. By the end of the day, I'm going to hope that he falls off the roof. Probably. So annoying if you let's see where this gets us. Syntax error. Binds for TCP sockets, and UDP socket is also a lot of stuff, not a lot, so we need to take care of that as well. I'm just doing the whole thing. So yeah, TCP socket, that stuff. It's actually listening on a TCP socket, or connecting to a TCP socket, creating and yeah, listening actually. Except, so this is going to need more. This if you listen, then you also need to be able to accept. That's something that you learn after a while. It's a matter of patterns and identifying patterns. But if you're listening on a socket, then you're listening because you're expecting something to connect, and if something is connected, then you'll probably want to accept that connection. And finally, hello. take a sip of the coffee. Oh, that's nice. That's my lifeblood. Pitch black coffee. Alright, so I'll search. Give me a break, please. 916. Now let's just make that 9. Other to allow. That's loud. That's less far. The messages, because there are some, there is deepest chatting going on here, to be exact. So it's basically 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 42, something like that. Just to make sure that you have it. Tail N, and this not, and this is M. Tail N 42, are too loud. Take care of deepest chatting. So that I can get that out of the way for at least for a part. Okay. So this is actually duo. This not, but this is the shell is. And DVFSD is probably going to be needing to chat to all kinds of DVFSD components later on. It's basically another pattern, because DVFSD itself is just a hub which basically runs components. Yeah, I don't often use this application, so it's probably I just have to try it out and see what functionality I should allow or not allow. Damn, it's going to get a warm day, a hot day. The sun is shining. It's not a good day to stand on a roof, that's for sure. So, okay, so let's have a look at this application again. So let's try this open and see if it opens that full file dialog, and it does. So that means we need to take care of a lot of stuff. That means we need to basically take care of search of the recently used stuff. We need to take care of probably DTK bookmarks. Not sure, but we'll see. There's a lot of stuff going on. Here we have dconf finally popping up. DTK. let's do first things first. And then go to this stuff here. Yeah, we need to have that recently used functionality, so you can basically just get that as well. From file roller, I guess. Somewhere a little bit where it belongs. I guess here you could add it. But this is related. Then I just basically need to take a look at whether FileRoller does some GTK stuff, and if it does, yeah, then I probably just need this as well. So this here can actually be removed because we already had that. Let's take care of that. Now if you look further, then here is actually creating the files. This is actually a transmission file. Well, not actually, but it's going to be also a transmission file probably. Let's have a look. But in this case, it's probably with regard to recently used or GTK. Yeah, it's actually GTK bookmarks. So, but I know that at some point. So we have ICE authentication of ICE out, and we have pulse audio read, and we have bash read. And then basically, because that was with events. Oh, what did I do it last? I have none. So here basically this one here. Probably also need to read metadata. So I'm going to copy this whole bit over here. It's common, and if the sandbox is a bit more coarse than needed, then that's not really a problem. And the remaining stuff just needs to be ignored. But actually, it just needs to read and write content there. That's just pretty obvious. So I'm going to actually add that anyways, generic content, access to generic content. And then just only do it for a file or something. Like file roller should be applicable. File roller also does it there, creates there. Yeah, it does, doesn't it? This in and I'll change that a little bit. This is fine. And this is fine. Basically creating a file in there and reading it. File. I'm reading generic files. But this here, I don't think, I'm not sure if this makes sense, if it actually creates directory, so I'm going to remove that one. And that's then also for here, that dir, that I'm not sure if it's actually needing to create dirs, but if it does, then but for now not. And then basically also add this rule, but only use it to have a comment it out. And then also, yeah, that's it, basically. And that's also why you well, that's fine. There's a lot of small tidbits that can be optimized and improved, that's for sure. There's a lot of tidbits that needs to be optimized and changed. Can't actually really test this one either. Because yeah, I don't even have a torrent file and I would need to get that from URL. So that would be possible. Now this should actually create that file in config. The transmission here, so we can get some new stuff here now. It's probably creating a file now. Yeah, it's kind of messy, so let's just take take it a little bit later. It's reading the conf. It's getting attributes of. So there's a bunch of stuff here. Let's have a look at config on tree. Should just relabel that stuff. See, that's transmission here. What it does is the following. This deconfuses get attribute. What it does, this is basically all with regard to transmission. So it's writing a file, creating a file, renaming a file, then it's removing the dir and unlinking the file. But I'm going to just do it this way. It's a bit chaotic this morning. It's a bit chaotic. So let's just add it in here. Now this file can be just taken care of like this. But this here can be added here, remove name. So this can be removed. Let's just take care of that. And now we have also reading deconf config. We have a get attribute of proc. I can also add that already. Proc t file get attribute. So yeah, deconf config home t, that's here. So it's already allowed to search config. Here. But we need to basically allow this without this. What else do we have? We have it actually listing homebrew t, and we're not going to allow that. But we silently deny that probably. Now it's getting attributes of lost found there. It's not going to. We're not going to allow that. And we're not going to allow it quota db access. So that's about it for now. Let's restore the context of that of the file once we actually built this. Oh damn, always something. You need to remember something, then you always have something interfering. And I'm again basically not doing what I say one should do, because I should have just first taken care of the transitions. But basically I did it in one run. I just set up the transitions and made some assumptions, but you should really not do that. First do the transitions, then basically either then just basically remove everything and let it transition properly first, type transition to the transmission directory in config, and then once you verify that that transition actually works, then just start over again and do the remainder properly. But now I did all that stuff in one run. It's just a bad idea in general, unless you are very familiar with that concept of the effects that a type transition can have. You should not do it. You should just basically take care of the transitions first and then move on. But I'm just trying to save time, which is basically stupid. You should just really take it easy. So again, a case of do as I say, not as I do. Alright, so that's done. Let's just click this a couple of times so that the thing doesn't kick in. The screensaver. So we basically allowed it to inhabit the hibernation, which is basically the block suspend. But we don't see that. Popping up. Let's see if it's by now chatting some more to some other components. Yeah, it does. So now it's actually chatting to dconf as well. And here actually Aves. So we have a bunch more chatting going on, like I expected it would. So let's say about 50 or probably 50 or something. I'll try that previous one if I still have it. Not really. Like that. 60. Yeah, these. So add this one in as well. It's doing more chatting. Which was expected already. I said it when I added the GVFSD. I said, okay, then it's probably going to chat to many of these components, these GVFSD components. Because GVFS is just basically a main hub to the other components. But you can't assume that. You just need to confirm, because it's not chatting to all the GVFS, the components, just the applicable ones to transmission. So yeah, really with these large projects, really your enemy is rushing and assuming and stuff like that. You really need to just stick to the checklist and do it the way you should do it, because else you're going to eventually allow stuff by accident that you should not have done, and that you would not have done if you did it the right way. This is going to open the web browser. Ouch. So it doesn't actually run Yelp at all. That sucks. The help function, or the content, this is actually running Yelp. No, it's not running Yelp at all. So that's another good example of why you shouldn't assume. Basically, what I thought was when you run contents, it's going to open Yelp, but this doesn't. This actually doesn't, so we can remove the Yelp stuff because it doesn't actually run Yelp. See, assumption is the mother of all fuck ups. So now I would have allowed it to run Yelp while it doesn't even run Yelp. It just opens the manual page in the web browser. Anyway, so I can't use this stuff. So I'm going to just log out and clean all the directory up, because now it's all messed up. What a mess. It's really a Monday morning. Kill all. You, my login user. Clear my login user shell. Alice all Z temp. RF temp. And now we're about to stage that we're going to do as a module DB. So yeah, don't assume things. That's the main message here. And ls all z. Oh, my login. Here we go. See that Mozilla dir needs to go. It's just mislabeled. So now we're back. I'll search MABCTS 945. We're clean. And now from our 945, we just need to start all over again. So now it's going to log all kinds of stuff that we shouldn't. That's probably needing to connect to the system bus for network manager or something, because obviously this is a network application. I accept. So let's have a look. So this is all stuff that we can ignore. Some stuff that went all the way wrong. But this is with regard to Mozilla. No, actually not. Yeah, it's probably an old Mozilla file there. That was still there. Because we ran Mozilla, yeah, just ignore this. It shouldn't be there. This is due to the fuck up that we did earlier. But this is stuff we need to add. And it's basically only the UDP socket, not the XDM. You can ignore that. So far, not much. So that's UDP socket. Read write. Then just add that here as well. Okay, that's it so far. Let's see in the meanwhile what it takes to download something using BitTorrent. So we have this Fedora project, and which basically should have some info about how to download something. BitTorrent. So I'll just take this, copy this link. Let's see if I can set this up. Open URL. Doesn't actually do that. That means that for some reason my agent isn't fully functioning, is it? So I need to type that in manually, torrent fedora project org torrents. Torrent fedora project org torrent. And then what else? And then that stupid Fedora 18, it's 64. Fedora 18. X86. 64. No, this is going wrong all the way. Live desktop torrent. I can't even type Fedora, right? Guess I'm going to So now it's doing something. Oh, ships. So now we have some new stuff here. First, add this. This is basically DNS stuff, this. It's reading the routing table. And then it's basically doing some stream connect stuff. But the most important thing is that TVFSD spawns a new daemon. Probably TVFSD HTTP. So let's go where we should go, probably somewhere here, paste that in here, and then basically just add that in here. Okay, save and exit, and then I'll have a look at execute and see what it's grab execute, of course. Shell. No, this is it. So we need to confine this stuff here. So yeah, that's what we need to do. We had to do it eventually. It was inevitable. But the fortunate thing is that we can actually borrow this stuff right from here. So that's fortunate. Just need to replace some stuff. But we could basically make it much simpler and just say we could basically, but that's later for optimization. But there's a much cleaner way to take care of this stuff. What I don't understand is why can't I just copy an URL onto my virtual machine? Okay, so let's just do first things first, make it, and make sure that you actually restore the context of this file here. Once you installed it. Not needed, but it's set. So yeah, we need to just basically log off again and go over again. It happens. Noise coming in, but that's all just parts and joints. So yeah, clean. Let's just log in. I'm going to try this another way. So let's just copy this URL. Damn. At least we have a URL here. So yeah, we are back in. Open that piece of dunk. Nah, it's a cool app. Accept. Open URL. Can't paste it in. How annoying. I can't believe that functionality isn't even working. It's just nope, it's not freaking working. Okay, then just do it the stupid way. Annoying as hell. Let's just get this one here so that I don't have to opt up all the time. Just enter this one. So, HTTP. Torrent Fedora. Project org torrents fedora 18 x86 64 live desktop, and then it's torrent. Doesn't seem to be doing anything. That's all good. This is, seems to be all okay. Now we have GVFS, the FTP doing stuff. Transmission. It's actually stream connecting to SFTP. Are you kidding me? The hell? I did something wrong. I can sense that. I forgot to do something. Jesus Christ. Oh man, it's really going very... So I need to go all the way down. That's weird. So why is it actually going to... Doesn't make sense. Doesn't make sense. What's happening there? See, this is SFTP. There's really a bug somewhere. No, it's... What's happening? What it's saying here is that SFTP should be an entry point for HTTP, so that's basically, that looks like a bug to me in my policy. But it doesn't seem to be a bug. Oh yeah, it is. Okay, all over again. That's what you get. You get punished for making stupid mistakes. Log off. Clean. Okay. Now this time hopefully doing it right. but there is no actual torrent available. That sucks. So it doesn't actually download anything because there's nothing available. Okay, we're going, let's go all over again. Here now at least we have a proper transition. Now at least we're transitioning properly. But yeah, this is actually a component that we should have taken care of anyway, so this is a good time to just do it. But let's just take care of the stream connect first, so that we don't forget that one. Because our transmission is actually stream connecting, and this is a leak. I think, but I'm going to allow it anyways, but it's probably a leak. The read-write is probably a leak. And let's just figure that out. And let's just make a note. The read-write is probably a leaked file this week. So that's for later, for when I'm doing my optimization. Alright, now go all the way down and start fixing this stuff here. So let's do the easy stuff first. We have the conf temp. See? So the nice thing is that these components all connect to different ports. So the SMB browser connects to the Samba port, and this one connects the HTTP component connects to the HTTP port, so you can basically use that to restrict access to various ports, so that's pretty neat. And then we have the config home. Which is this one? Basically, they all do the same stuff except connect to different ports. I can basically just put this stuff open, see then where it gets us. But they all do the same stuff. So for example, it needs to search home root and use a home directory. That's obvious because it wants to get to data home key and stuff like that. So let's remove that first then. This is basically this one here. Doesn't actually show the home root key, but you can bet your ass that it's there. Then it's config, the config stuff. And then cache, it serves cache, they all search cache for one reason or another. Stream connecting to the session bus, to the user session bus, so that's going to be chatting. It's going to get service on there. It's reading the netconfig file, which is basically for DNS resolve. DNS resolve. So let's remove some of this stuff already. This can be removed. The data search, that cannot be removed yet. This can be removed. This can be removed, this can't be removed, but this can be removed. Netconf can also be removed. And then we have password, which can stay in there. And these can also in there. It's basically just stuff needed to connect. This is basically reading the routing table, and this is basically actually connecting to the HTTP port. Basically the data home key, let's just get out of the search. Let's see if SMB browse does something in data home key, then we can be pretty sure that it's doing the same thing. But it doesn't seem to. Don't have anything yet with regard to that. So yeah, this should be itself for now. Not that much, but it's something. Okay, and let's have a look at last file log message. Probably DBS chatting to GVFS D. It's actually requiring servers and stuff. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now let's just do 10. They're not all as interesting, but so this is one way, this is both two ways. So there are some nice things in here that you can use for a conditional policy. Because this needs to be able to connect to HTTPD. So not the user itself, but only this program, and you could basically just make that conditional. So if you don't want to enable HTTP functionality, then you can basically either block the transition to GPFS, the HTTP, instead of making it really ugly like if you wouldn't have confined that. Alright. And we have some, of course, some missing requirements. Which is the HTTP port require type HTTP port B. Might be more that I need to require. Actually not. So that's done. Screensaver kicked in. It's not downloading anything. Because there are no peers, probably. Oh, you need to actually open it, of course. So yeah, that's going to bring some new ABC denials, obviously, or probably. So, yeah. Hell yeah. So it's creating cache content. And then it's connecting all kinds of stuff. Actually connecting to Tor port. Basically probably needs to connect to almost anything. Why is it connecting to privileged ports? Is it actually connected? This is not saying that it's connecting to privileged port. Grab connect. Because there's also HTTP ports that are not 80. So here it's connect. Yeah, it's actually connecting to 80. And here it's connecting to TCP socket. We need to name connect. And these are all high ports. So let's take care of this stuff here. What it's doing is transmission. At this, yes, here. So this need we need to take care of this later. First, let's take care of this of this port. So it actually needs to connect to HTTP. This is actually straight up port 80. And then with TCP socket, we already had that, didn't we? Self TCP socket. We did. So yeah, so we can basically extend that. So TCP socket and extend that. TCP socket, paste that in. And then just extend that here. And then remove that from here. But these others just unreserved port types. So we just need to basically, and I'm not sure if that attribute actually exists. So I'm gonna try that out. Unreserved port. And then it's required, and of course, unreserved port type. I could just check it out. The hell is that? Oh, that's already done. So it's already done. That was fast. So that means that we need to check that out as well. We also need to check out cache. Grab cache. With creating caching stuff. Create cache. In favicons. But we can basically ouch, that sucks. Oh yeah, cache transmission. So we can basically take care of cache transmission here. Copy that. Transmission, cache transmission. FC. Cache. Transmission. Transmission. Transmission cache on T. T transmission, and then basically we have a transmission type, and I'm going to add that with the cache stuff that we need to take care of. So we have type transmission cache on T. Type attribute transmission cache empty and it's a file type, and I use a home type, and then we basically need to take care of this. So it needs to basically this, we copy this over, it needs to write an add name, write add name, but also actually we already allowed it to search cache empty. So now we also know why it needed to search cache empty. I'm not sure where I allowed it, but I'm pretty sure I have. What a mess. Bad day. Bad day, boys. I'm also getting this stuff. I thought I allowed it somewhere to actually traverse cache. This is not user home t dir create. So it's actually creating a dir inside user home. Where do I have that? Yeah, give me a break. There, and then it's also a lot of other stuff as well, but this is at least a start. So it needs to also actually transition, probably only needs to transition the so this is done. Where was I? Oh yeah, cache. So, why is there no cache search? I would have sworn I allowed that. Well, then it actually needs to search, get attribute and search cache. It's that simple. I would have sworn I'd get attribute search. This is actually create, and it's also get attribute and search. And this is basically for type transmission cache empty. And this is for transmission. So write, remove search, blah blah. Rename, create open read, right, that seems to be okay. If this actually, I think the epermal ports are also, I need to take a look at that. Where am I? Okay, SE info XA epermal port type. Shit, that is such a fucking stupid name. We just grab. Port type. Ephemeral. What a name. What a. Never heard of it. But it does, it's not assigned to unreserved portee. Let's have a look at this one. Doesn't have, that sucks. Yeah, by just using unreserved port type, I'm also catching other types. Actually, no. The way this is working is weird. No, I really need to explicitly allow, allow that, because, and I'll at least group them. Because, and I'll explain that to you. So basically, all types that are classified ephemeral ports are also classified unreserved ports. But all ports that are not labeled and are ports that are in a certain range get the ephemeral port, but ephemeral port T is not classified unreserved port T, and that is basically a bug, as far as I'm concerned. I think that this port ephemeral, yeah, well, I can't even fucking write that stuff. Ephemeral port T should be classified unreserved port type, because unreserved port type is anything over 1024, and ephemeral port T is somewhere in the range of 40,000 to 60,000 or something like that, something very high, but it's also in the range of unreserved port. So actually, and I took a look at that, and I can take a look at it again, but the ephemeral port T-type is just not classified unreserved port type. Type ephemeral, what a name. Port T. So that's, as far as I'm concerned, that's just a bug. I'll make it a question mark. See if this builds. It does build. But we need to take care of other stuff first, because we did some things. I'm not sure what, I forgot what it exactly was, but we did some stuff that, holy moly, oh yeah, pulls audio. It finished that download and then it's basically messing with pulls audio. Shit. Oh my god, opening up a can of worms here. See, now we also have this stuff here where pulls audio is getting, so yeah, we need to think. I'm going to first take a look at this stuff here. So what does that stand for? I read transform specified type into a file system type which does not have. This interface call is generated by Jesus. Okay. So Pulse Audio, we basically open up a real can of worms. I think that this GTK app of this what is it, transmission app, basically is a little bit unmaintained. Not sure, but because why would it actually need to connect to Pulse Audio? I'm not sure, but sure, back in the old days, back in the Fedora 14 days, then yeah, each of these apps that use Pulse Audio needs to actually do some stuff to Pulse Audio. But I was hoping actually that in more recent desktop environments this would have changed, but well, obviously not for this here. She's running Canberra. Messy, messy, messy. I just need to take a look at that. But it's ugly. One of those things that are less nice, then you have to investigate what's going on. Okay, this is transmission, creating the transmission there. We took care of that. Oh yeah, we need to actually make sure that we good stuff. Here is connecting. Connecting, 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 accepting. Here we have Canberra. So what we have here is transmission GTK running Canberra. So we need to domain transition to Canberra. So what runs Canberra? Our transmission needs to run it as well. And that changes the whole scenario, which basically means that we need to reproduce this shit. So G-Session runs Canberra, but not just G-Session. We should make it run Canberra probably, but this program is really taking its different approach. Transmission is really taking its different approach to things. For example, doesn't run Yelp. Instead, it just decides, okay, I'm going to redirect to a website, and now all of a sudden it's using Canberra for its sound notifications. Couldn't it just directly connect to Pulse Audio? So really, I'm going to do as, oh, that's not nice for the people that are hosting these hosting these torrents, because now I'm going to have to re-download it all over again a couple times. So these boys are seeding, they're working hard to seed, and I'm just downloading and downloading and downloading just to test this stuff. And it's easy for me to see, say, with a 100 megabit connection. But these boys probably hosting it on dial-ups. Nah, not dial-ups, but not dial-ups. Let's have a look at this. Okay, so enough with this stuff. I need to just go and do it all over again. This is really turns out to be a nasty, and I'm uploading. Oh, that's so sad. But sitting to two connected peers, but they aren't actually downloading anything. So these guys must be on 56k or something, because they don't actually. Oh, two. So now it's only one user. Must be a very slow connection, because I got myself like 100 megabits. So oh man, that sucks so bad, this. Yeah, you gotta do it. It's part of your job, part of your hobby. And you need to learn to enjoy it and don't give a shit about. The collateral damage. So this video is going to be rated X, because I'm basically cussing a lot in this episode, so I should rate this X. Don't want any kids to listen to this stuff. Probably going to be cussing a lot in this episode. Because hell, this is so messed up to basically reproduce all this stuff. At least I'm not taking a big ISO, I'm just taking a small one. The smallest one that is available. And it's legal stuff. Aw, man, give me a break. Give me a break. Open it up. Okay, so now I'm going to have to download this all over again. done yet? Almost. It's not very fast. Oh yeah, downloading at 3 megabits bytes second. 95 peers, so I don't have to really worry about that stuff. Now let's hope I taken care of all the transitions properly. But probably not. I'm going to have to do this the really hard way. Seems easy, but it really isn't. Ding. So Canberra wants to read system state. So this does actually solve a lot of stuff, seems so far. Now here, this stuff is not applicable. But here you have some stuff we need to take care of. So that transition to Canberra changed the whole scenario. So let's just add that to Canberra. Canberra wants to read proc, so that's fine. And then let's have a look at cache empty. Grab it, of course. Okay. Yeah, it's creating that door. Damn, I thought I took take care of this stuff. Guess not. I guess not. Of course. I'm always messing up something. There's no type transition. I forgot to add the type transition. And then that of course won't work. See, I have to learn the hard way. Really the hard way. Well, at least we have something. Some of these apps are really, really annoying. Because I don't use these apps often. I don't use BitTorrent often. Watch before you press enter. That's allowed. It's all not applicable. XDN is all allowed. This is not related anymore. This. can ignore that. That was basically left from a previous, there shouldn't be any. Yeah, so it seems that all is fine now. Let's have a look at less far log messages, because there might be some deepest chatting. Actually, there is some deepest chatting, most likely. Now we have an invalid gnome keyring daemon. Doesn't seem to be any deepest chatting. Well, there is deepest chatting, but it's there's some bugs going on. That's because we're in permissive mode, by the way. Probably. So, we need to get the AVC denials, but from the user. Because it's probably, it might actually be chatting to Pulse Audio. No, it's not. So there's not much chatting going on. All right, so log out again. Oh man, that sucks. That's the third. This is going to be the third time that I'm downloading the same ISO. This is the. I'm going to do this now in a forcing mode. Hopefully I'll speed this up a little bit, because I don't want to make this any harder than it is already. Let's first see if there's some stuff in a dev sham. Make sure that is gone. See, there are still, but it's DDM, so if it's DDM, then it's fine. And all the user stuff should be Pulse Audio temp, yeah, that's fine. So this looks good, there's no tempfst files in here, so that's clean. And then get rid of this. Send them for us. One audit to allow 1104. Let's just hopefully we're advancing a little bit, because I'd like to get this done ASAP. At least it starts in a forcing mode. Let's see what we have so far. Oh, this is user ABC. Damn. But other than that, we're on the right track. So we want to search dconf and wants to basically get the cache. Yeah. No. A data. It wants to get the data. And that's basically this, yeah. Should have known that. I could have known that. So that's another one of those negligence. That's my negligence on my... side part. But yeah, it's Monday morning, almost Monday noon, but yeah. Testing. Let's just do this. So we're enforcing, just so you know. Some, I don't know why has become invalid. Doesn't look invalid to me. So we have this process, you have GTK, and then you have DVFS. And it's actually downloading something. Poor guys. Sorry guys, but this is let's just assume this is for the greater good. Let's just assume that this is for the greater good. Yeah, everything else seems fine. At least it's doing its thing also. Oh, I'm sorry. ding, almost, if not, or not. So, sorry for the coughing. That usually means that we have a storm coming up, or we have some wet weather coming up, usually, not always, or usually a change in weather when I start coughing. I'm very sensitive to the weather. My respiratory system, my and it's the forecast, the weather forecast also said that we're going to have thunder, lightning, because we have some cold air and some hot air colliding. Ding. Okay, now let's have a look. Oh, we have tr extract reading xcd file. But other than that, looks pretty solid. So tr extract is reading xcd config home. Gonna add that here, and that's basically read open get attribute. It's reading that xcd config file. That's okay. So yeah, so far so good. Come on. But this isn't all the functionality. This is the new. Save the desktop, first file, trackers, blah blah blah, command, predator, and. Can actually add bookmarks. I'll just add this one. It's a bookmark. And I'll go try and add a folder here. Oh, are we in permissive of enforcing? Enforcing, but it's all working. That's weird. Oh, we have Canberra searching GTK home. You gotta be kidding me, why is that? Why is Canberra searching GTK home? That's just so weird. But it is actually Canberra doing it, so why would Canberra have anything to do with bookmarks? Oh, actually, there's not just bookmarks in there. There's also other stuff in there. Let's just have a look at that. What kind of stuff is there? There's also other G-Stream stuff, maybe. So LSLZ home, my login user. I keep thinking that there's only bookmarks in there, but that's not true. And that's basically local data, local share. No. Config. Yeah. GTK 3.0. Yeah, there's only bookmarks in there currently. But that's not it. There's also other stuff there, and it might actually make sense. Should make sense. Everything should make sense. So config. GTK. Oh, just shit. I haven't specified that properly, so I can't really tell from this. But I think that there's also some GStreamer stuff going to be in there eventually. But let's just. I can't just go and. Assume that's just not going to work, so I'm just going to have to allow it to search. For now. That's it for now. I can't really do much more than that. Transmission there is created with the right context. That's obvious. That's less. This is so weird. But it only happened, so it's not happening again. No buffer space available. Yeah, because might be a good idea to restart this system once in a while, because I'm just really raping it. I'm just really raping it. So yeah, that's what I'm going to actually do. Remove this bookmark. Remove this there. I can't actually remove it, can I? good. This is all gravy. Yeah, so far so good. But yeah, of course, we also need to do it without the so I'm gonna reboot this first. I'm gonna log out nicely, and then I'm gonna reboot it. And then I'm going to do it without the denials. I don't add it. First things first. Yes, some of this stuff is really just and this is going to be deleted anyways, but okay, I'll just do it. Just this is shared memory. And I'm going to reboot. Sucks. It really sucks, but I gotta do it. That's the way I am. I gotta do it, that's the way I am. I'm too rude to say yes, ma'am. I don't give a damn. So it's basically shut down, reboot now. Oh, I forgot to do the ASCII module dance. Ships. We have a new kernel. Okay, so we need to re-log in. And then sudo shell. And cd my login user. ASCII module b. Now I'm going to have a close look at what's going on. So less far log messages. This cannot analyze if I don't know that, that's okay. Don't think this is actually. Look at how it's spamming. I don't know what that is all about. Can I force? It's enforcing. So let's just log in. So we're enforcing, we have FC denials silently denied. We have a real clean home directory. It's just kinda empty. We're going to do the transmission dance. Oh, and this is gonna show FC denials, by the way. Yeah, this is all from TTI. Nothing. Oh, oh, mess. Nothing. Seems okay. No more error messages with regard to DKRD. So yeah. Okay. So that's fine for now. We're empty, aren't we? That's pretty cool. So no AFC denials with regard to that. Cancel that. Let's just open the URL again once more. Hopefully this will be one of the last times, because I don't want to be a abuser. It still seems to all work. So at least this functionality works. But it's slow though, currently. Oh no, it's getting quicker. Poor guys. Now. So now if I basically click these buttons, it won't work. Because it's not allowed to run it. See? I see now. It basically wanted to open the browser, but that's not allowed. Statistics. Just playing a little bit. So yeah, it wants to actually read the home root, but I'm not going to allow that. none of your business. That's none of your business. They basically wants to read or list slash home. That's none of its business. And then, okay, it throws an error message. Now, fine. Then go ahead and throw an error message. I don't care. I don't care about that. But we need to basically support other functionality as well. But this is just default, but we need to basically allow it to create a new torrent. And also allow it to open a torrent from file. But I can't currently just test that. But at least we have the basic setup. Seems. So that's something. But so far, so good, I guess. So I'm downloading at about 40 megabits. That's my down speed. My up speed is about 100. Well, not actually 100. But actually, I pay for about 40 or actually 35. But somehow, these guys aren't able to cap it properly. So basically, my down speed is about 35, or yeah, around about 35-40, and my up speed is about 80. So basically, 100 megabits, kind of like. Enough. I'm not gonna pay extra to get an official 100 megabits. Don't really need it. Although it would be nice, but I don't have the money for that. Bing! Let's have a look. Oops. No, that's it. That's just it. So yeah, we're done. But we can basically yeah, it's fine. So I'll leave it at this. So although there are plenty loose ends with regard to transmission, at least it has some basic functionality. But that's basically the remainder is basically up to whatever. Now there's no one connected, so I don't have to worry about seeding. Oh yeah, I need to basically silently deny these. So I'll do that. That's one thing I forgot. I added it, but I didn't comment it out yet. So I'll comment it out. Okay, so let's just do that manually. Nano, my login. User type enforcement file, and then go to transmission. And then somewhere is a comment. This is a bug. This is it. I make F because Okay. And I could also don't audit that attempt to read, or maybe I actually did that. No, I didn't, else wouldn't. Yeah, actually, maybe I'll take, I have taken care of that. Okay, so yeah, basically, you know, recently used, so I can basically create stuff here. Copies file location. Thought I was able to actually create something in here, but not anymore, I guess. Strange. Probably some limitation due to some things that I denied. Actually, I was able to create a bookmark there. Desktop, save to desktop, source folder, public source, source file. Let's now create their option. Anyways, this is this stuff that I actually need to work on. See if I can clear this. Remove it anyways. None uploaded. Okay, once more. This is don't audit it. This. Yeah, we're basically done. So I'll leave it at that for this episode. It has some basic functionality, but not everything. Guess that's just the way it is.